know that at the first Oscars in 1928 there was no Best Picture award? Instead, they actually gave two prizes. Most Outstanding, aka, wow, this thing was huge and awesome and brought so much work to town. Good job! And Most Artistic, aka, wow man, that stuff was deep. Good job! Huh. Maybe they ought to try that again sometime. You know, a month ago when I did the episode on Oscar nominations, the movie to beat for Best Picture was Avatar. Now, with the awards rapidly approaching, things look a little different, with top-rated rival The Hurt Locker having won the equivalent of Best Picture from basically every movie award ceremony in existence, which kinda makes it a more likely lead. So, looks like we're gonna do this dance again. Look, guys, I really, really, really liked The Hurt Locker. It's a perfectly serviceable, great, really, solid, very well-directed, low-budget action movie. But that's kinda it. It's been positioned as the substance-over-style anti-Avatar alternative, but from where I sit, those two are more like peas in a pod. Neither one has much going on under the surface, neither one has an especially memorable screenplay. They're both basically director-driven technical exercises. Mine is bigger versus it's all in how you use it. Oh, but this one cost less and wasn't as widely seen, so it must be some sort of meaningful, important thing, right? Right. So let's all pop on our berets and Banksy shirts and pretend like war is a drug, is any better of an ersatz profundity than trees are nice, and do the huzzah for small movies, a pox on corporate art kabuki dance. Feh. Whatever. This is where we seem to be. Two viscerally stimulating, fundamentally shallow movies standing in for David and Goliath, which wouldn't really be all that irritating if not for both of them having a superior alternative nominated in the same category. District 9 does man's inhumanity to man sci-fi allegory much better than Avatar did, and Inglourious Basterds has a lot more to say about the moral chaos of war with infinitely more depth and complexity than Hurt Locker did. Of course, that being said, regarding them as mutually overpraised equals doesn't mean I'm still not going to root for the one with the aliens and robots, because, hey, I gotta be me. Interestingly, there still could be an upset whereby something else could win the big prize. See, when the Academy switched to 10 nominations, they also switched from a simple which-one-did-you-like ballot to a preferential ballot. Here's how that works. See, there's about 5,800 voting members of the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences, culled from all the major disciplines in American filmmaking. Everyone votes for nominations in the category they belong to. Actors vote for actors, directors vote for directors, ninjas vote for ninjas, and so on. But everyone votes on the final awards, and everyone has a say on Best Picture. Before, you just had to pick which one you liked best. Now, in a preferential ballot, you have to rank them all, from favorite to least favorite. Then, you separate all the ballots in order of number ones. Whichever movie got the least number one votes gets eliminated, and all the number twos in that pack become new number ones and get shuffled back in with the rest, and you go another round. This repeats until there's a clear winner. The fun thing with preferential voting is that the top and bottom spots tend to be based on love it or hate it personal passions, which means lots of diversity at the top and bottom, but more consensus in the middle. So, let's say hypothetically that this leads all 10 nominees to split the number ones more or less evenly in the first round, meaning they'd all have to get between 9 and 11% of the total vote. Yes, I know that's statistically improbable, but that's why it's called hypothetical. Anyway, they'd start canceling one another out pretty quickly. However, while in this scenario only maybe 500 people thought, oh, let's say Up in the Air was good enough to be number one, what if almost everyone liked it enough to make it the second or third choice on almost all the ballots? Well, that could propel it to a victory by mathematical consensus and process of elimination. Cool, right? So if that happened, who would it be? Well, think about what the Academy likes. They like actor-driven movies, with big casts, and history, especially World War II, and movies that were well-reviewed, and people who've been nominated but never won before. Huh, who does that sound like? Yeah, now how cool would that be? All right, that's probably not going to happen, but if you're looking for a dark horse surprise upset so you can look like Mr. Prescient in your office pool, I'd say Bastards is the most likely candidate. Just don't complain to me if you lose any money. Anyway, Sunday, March 7th is the show, so we'll find out then. If you're wondering about the acting, writing, and directing races, go back and watch the other video, because that stuff hasn't changed at all. See you next time.